doctors prescribing placebos for patients. Many call the practice unethical, but doctors admit to doing it anyways to make their patients feel better. This morning, Dr. Barry Ramo reveals why it's not necessarily a good idea.
Placebos or sugar pills are used to compare an active drug to one that has no biological effect. A recent survey, however, found that about half of U.S. doctors regularly give their patients placebos. Number one on the list, vitamins, which unless you're vitamin deficient, some people believe are no more than expensive urine. The other group of medications are over-the-counter pain relievers, such as Tylenol or Aleve. These pills don't cure anything, but because many illnesses are self-limited, they think that the medication was actually a cure. Placebos do work. In fact, studies of brain activity using functional MRI scans have suggested that placebos can produce effects on brain activity similar to the active drug. So simply believing a drug will make you feel better seems to give the treatment real power. But since only 5% of the doctors surveyed tell their patients they're getting a placebo, some have questioned the ethics of such prescribing. The American Medical Association says physicians should not use placebos on their patients. And some of the pills that doctors use, which fall into the placebo category, such as sedatives or antibiotics, can have serious side effects.
The power of the placebo is profound. There are many studies that show that there are physiologic changes that go on in the brain function when an individual takes a placebo. Also, placebos help people feel better. The problem that doctors have is trying not to be deceptive while at the same time giving their patients the benefits of a placebo effect. For Healthbeat, I'm Dr. Barry Ramo, KOAT Action 7 News, live this morning.